So it's second against seventh in the Isuzu Ute A-League Men's when these two met in the decider last season. Who knew that getting back to the top of the mountain would present as many challenges as it has? As you can see there, it's a perfect night for football at Industry Group Stadium in Gosford as the Central Coast Mariners take on Melbourne City. And there they are in the tunnel thanks to Isuzu Ute Tunnel Cam. Melbourne City paying homage to their Melbourne Heart roots with that kit with the red sash, and the Central Coast Mariners wearing their regular home kit. Great to see Woi Woi there represented among the mascots, and lots of youngsters wearing the colours of their home clubs on the Central Coast. They do such a great job at grassroots level, and the Mariners always reaching out and connecting with those young players who are aspiring to one day walk out onto the pitch wearing the shirt of the senior team. Lots of focus in the eyes of the players as they get set to do battle. It's a very even head-to-head record historically. Central Coast 14 wins, Melbourne City 16 and the 9 draws. However, the last four head-to-heads, Melbourne City are winless, dating back to December 2022. And Melbourne City's last win in Gosford was 2 years ago now, back in January of 2022. They've been defeated on their last two trips here to the venue. So it is a Tuesday night contest, a grand final rematch. Central Coast Mariners got the win back in January last time they met, and that is perhaps reflected in the win probability here as they shade Melbourne City. Let's take a look at how the teams line up. Central Coast make two changes to the team defeated by Sydney FC on Saturday. Nathan Paul and Miguel DiPizio, a couple of the young guns, are preferred in the starting 11, with Christian Theoharis and Bradley Tapp moving to the sidelines. No changes otherwise to the matchday squad of Mark Jackson. Plenty of firepower on that bench. Theoharis, Qual and Jing Reese all waiting on the sidelines. Ryan Edmondson has just the one goal so far this season, but continues to be entrusted to lead the line for the Central Coast Mariners. The English signing will be hoping that he can provide a target. Certainly his role has plenty of hot competition with both Reese and Qual capable of replacing him. So he'll be hoping to up that strike rate with just the one strike so far in the league this campaign. Melbourne City ring the changes. Ralph Napoli is still on the sidelines, deputising for the ill Aurelio Vidmar. Into the lineup come Terry Antonis, Alessandro Lapane and Curtis Good from the team that drew nil-all with Newcastle on Saturday. To the bench go Jimmy Jego and Samuel Suprayan. No Patrick Beach tonight. James Neuenhausen instead preferred as the backup goalkeeper. He would be making his debut if we see him tonight. No Leo Natel either in the matchday squad as Marco Tilio returns among the substitutes. And as City huddle up, Marin Yakalish, one goal in 18 now so far this season. But the goal did come against the Central Coast Mariners. He was at the centre of a bit of a squabble with his teammate Tolgay Arslan at the weekend, running into the path of Arslan and taking a shot, which Arslan thought was his. Mark Jackson, the Central Coast Mariners coach, knows how important finishing in the top two will be for his team as they juggle commitments in the AFC Cup. They've been to India, next stop Kyrgyzstan, and they have their eyes on the title and the big prize money that would come with going all the way. Ralph Napoli, second game in charge as interim to the interim. He's got Scott Jamieson there next to him on the Melbourne City bench, the former George Cross player who played under Joe Montemurro in the Victorian State Leagues back in his playing days. Tonight's referee is Johnny Barrero, the assistants are Andre Giev and Matthew McCorrist, fourth official Sam Kelly, and the VAR, should we require it, will be Chris Griffiths-Jones. Josh Nisbet, the freshly minted Socceroo, ready to come back and continue his sensational Isuzu Ute A-League Men's campaign. Terry Antonis will no doubt be trying to limit his influence on the contest, and it's Antonis who receives the back pass from kickoff. As we get this one underway, another grand final rematch between Central Coast Mariners and Melbourne City. Phil Moss, it's vital for both teams for very different reasons.
Don't let the calm conditions in Gosford fool you, Teo. There is so much on the line tonight for the Mariners to stay in touch with Wellington, of course, who they host this weekend, and Melbourne City absolutely desperate to give themselves a chance of making that top six and not missing out for, I can't remember how long.
2013-14, Mossy, so the best part of a decade. I can forgive you for not knowing why, as Melbourne City get a real feel for possession in the opening minute of the game. Lapane, one of the players, along with Curtis Good, restored to the starting 11. And as Melbourne City hold the ball, Mossy, do you think there'll be some long memories out there from the all-in sideline scuffle that resulted in Storm Roo's red card and a handful of yellows last time these teams met?
Well, it's not such a long memory, is it? It's only, what, 8-10 weeks ago, I think it was. I was up there calling that one, and it was quite remarkable how things just bubbled to the surface and then hit boiling point. But it just goes to show the rivalry that's built up between these two clubs, right back from the Mariners-Melbourne Heart days into the Melbourne City days. It's good for the league.
Mariners are yet to really touch the ball in the first 90 seconds. I suppose the one thing that does change it is City have got six different players in their starting 11 to the ones that squared off on January the 21st, such as the ebb and flow of the season, injuries and form. Yakalish wins a free kick here. Mikkel Dokker conceding the foul. So City, can they turn early dominance of possession into the first chance? Trying to set the tone and the tempo here by owning the ball. Tolgay Arslan. Switching over to Callum Talbot. Nuno Reyes had a goal disallowed for offside at the weekend. He nearly had goals in consecutive games after waiting 74 games for his first A-League men's goal. And speaking of offside, has intervened here to deny Lapane any forward progress.
Well, he's got shock written all over his face, Lapane, but you can't be offside from those situations. He's looking right across that line. The only one who may have slightly been guilty of keeping him onside was Nathan Paul at left back. Correct decision from the officials. Quick shout out to Aurelio Vidmar too. Hasn't been well, Teo, as you mentioned, in your opener, a great man, a great football man. Wishing you a very speedy recovery, Viddy.
Very tough to be watching on television rather than standing in the sideline when coaches feel such responsibility for their teams, but coaching staff didn't really miss a beat at the weekend. Ralph Napoli looked right at home in the technical area. And how much of a difference does coaching a team second time up make, Mossy? Because all the nerves of doing it for the first time are now out of the system, and just 3 days later he gets to do it again.
Yeah, it's a strange situation. I did it once at the Mariners when Graham Arnold was up in the grandstand for a week. But, you've just got to keep the ship sailing. And, look, it's a credit to Vidi's leadership that his staff didn't miss a beat on the weekend. He obviously gives them ownership behind the scenes. And when they need it, it was there for all to see.
Mariners trying to attack meaningfully for the first time tonight, and Edmondson's able to draw a foul immediately from Nuno Reyes, and that was the work of Nisbet to steal in and win the ball. And now, it's a free kick in a potentially dangerous position. And so the Mariners picked the right time to press in order to win possession high up the pitch. And now Edmondson will no doubt be among the targets here. Angel Torres and Max Ballard brainstorm what set piece they're going to send into the box. It is the left foot of Torres. Kaltak was chasing, but Fernandez got there first. Deflected off the back of the head of the Chilean. And out for a throw it goes, but the Mariners get the nod, so they will stay on the attack. Storm Roo wearing the protective headband tonight. He's got the John Eels look going with the electrical tape around the headband as well, but safety first.
Well, it just goes to show, Teo, when the Mariners get into that top third, they're dangerous. It's been a hallmark of their season. Melbourne City, we know they can keep possession. They've had 13 10-plus passing sequences this season, which puts them second in the A-League for keeping possession.
Right now, the Mariners showing us what they can do quick in transition, though. Edmondson trying to take on his marker in Reyes. And he's able to get the call. It's a couple of fouls within the first 5 minutes for Nuno Reyes. Edmondson there, not able to continue chasing his touch.
And again, effective possession from the Mariners. Look how quickly they go forward. Good touch from Edmondson. Plays it really well to draw the foul from Nuno Reyes.
Does he have a claim, or was his touch a little heavy to claim he could have chased it down?
Well, he didn't get the chance to show us, did he? And I think that's the point. Nuno Reyes, it was tough for him to get out of the way, but it's obstruction nonetheless. So happy with the call from Jonathan Barrero.
So this free kick, quite a bit further away from the penalty area. A new challenge for Jamie Young in A-League appearance number 222 tonight.
Looking resplendent in hot pink as well, we must say.
Ballard to take the free kick this time, drops it at the penalty spot, and again it's Fernandez who read it best in the air. He is able to get the clearance to the line. Talbot keeps it in. Reyes gets the call from Fernandez, his left back, and the first touch. Well, it invited Angel Torres on, but City keep possession. Lapane. Already showed us what he can do defensively, but as a wing back in a Melbourne City team, there's an expectation that he'll be able to show us what he can do going forward, as Talbot has on many an occasion over on the right side this season. And his link up with Yakalish was working well at the weekend against Newcastle. It doesn't quite come off with their first combination here on Tuesday. Happily standing, Scott Jamieson, the former Melbourne City captain and 300-game A-League men's veteran, currently in front of the touch screen. Perhaps getting an early handle on some of the numbers. There's Jamo. He's got the earpiece and the touch screen. Mossy is totally wired in.
I'm sure he is, Jamo, as he was as a player.
Max Caputo leading the press, and Paul is trying to escape here, Nathan Paul, for the Central Coast. Tap. Slow down to walking pace, and you see that Yakalish didn't like the sight of that. He came sprinting in, but that might leave a gap for Torres here to potentially exploit, along with Mikhail Docker. Popped over the top. Edmondson has just got a meter here on his marker, and even though his left-footed swing appeared to hit his own standing leg, he was offside.
Well, Yakalish fell for it. That's exactly what the Mariners were hoping for when they slowed things down, to invite the press, and as soon as Yakalish left his zone, they exploited that by playing through the lines.
Gee, tough call there on Edmondson, but the moment has passed. Now Talbot coming back. He's in space, drifting across field ball for Lapane. Shows a lot of it to Storm Ruben. The defender didn't have a nibble, and so Arslan, first chance to conjure in a cross, headed away by Kaltak. Yakalish. See, when Talbot comes forward from his right-back position, he likes to tuck into a more central right role here.
Well, it's just rotation, isn't it? We're seeing more and more teams play with inverted fullbacks, but being able to rotate players, Brisbane Roar and the Mariners, and Durant's Postecoglou, Graham Arnold, took rotations in the A-League to a whole new level.
And now things switch back with Lukakovic, unmissable in the golden boots. He's now back to that central midfield position, but he actually dropped into right back, Mossy, when Talbot went on that venturing forward run. So we'll watch for more of that as the game goes on. Garkovich in the number six shirt really is a beacon, though, with the Hot Wheels. One of a number of City players that were rueing missed shots on goal at the weekend. Here comes Fernandez, yet to score in the A-League, sends it to Lapane. And the cross finds the head of Caputo, but it's an up and under and an easy save. Veteran Danny Vukovic.
That's good from Melbourne City, though. A couple of incisive runs down the right-hand side and left-hand side now, with some delivery into the Mariners' box. Had a good spell of early possession without really going too far forward with it.
And they have sevenfold the number of passes in the attacking half so far in the game. Bogakovic. Now Talbot. So a bright first 10 minutes. Mariners showing what they're capable of on the counter. Melbourne City for the locksmith to undo the defence. Yakalish, first touch. Not able to find a teammate. Ballard and Nisbet combine. And Nisbet sold a dummy beautifully. What can he do with the space he created? Has to return back to the defence.
Well, it was smart from the Mariners too, setting up with a back five, three-man midfield, two up front, which allows them to track in the midfield and put real pressure on the ball.
Docker has got Angel Torres on the outside. Edmondson waits in the middle. A high cross that instead is going to bring Storm Rue into play. Miguel De Pizio, the 18-year-old playmaker. Torres. Mariners turn to possess the ball. They're being hurried though. Kaltak, Rue leaps. Fernandez was first to recover. Antonis immediately saw Ballard blocking his path, so he has to go back to his defence.
I'm not sure Storm Rue will be thankful for the last two deliveries wearing the headband as he is.
Sitting at the centre of defence. Nathan Paul, playing game number 12 tonight, the 20-year-old, former Sydney FC youth. He's going to get the hurry up here from Yakalish, so back to the last line. And Danny Vukovic, he has no choice but to go for distance. Edmondson, the target man, does his job, brings De Pizio into play. And Torres, nearly able to nick it off the toes of Talbot. He was able to streak away. Fernandez had numerous options in the middle.
Talbot did very well there in cover defence. He needed to be very, very watchful of that run from Angel Torres. He stayed true to his responsibility. Played his team out of danger. Very good defending.
With a little nibble at the heels of Arslan, who has so far had a couple of touches, but yet to really join Melbourne City in trying to dictate the tempo of the game. Antonis. A more direct pass. Yakalish not on the same wave. Tony Antonis with 5 goals to his name this season, which is a great return for the 30-year-old. 17 and 163 over his A-League career. So he's definitely had an eye for it, and some of them have been spectacular. He's probably the clubhouse leader for goal of the year. Rue up for the header, glancing on. Curtis Good hooks it away. Rue again, this time off the top of the chest, and then a header. Showed his juggling ability there, Storm Rue, and he got fouled for his trouble.
I think he thought about putting his head through it and then thought better of it again. Clearly protecting a gash to the head under that headband.
He's been a magnet to the headers so far in the game. Mossy, every aerial ball is going his way.
It's always the way, isn't it?
Had such an awful history of serious injuries, Storm Rue, during the course of his career. It's great to see him out there stringing consistent football and form together, the Kiwi international. Edmondson has already been made to do some pretty hefty target man striker work back to goal. Find a teammate with the initial throw, but Ogarkovic knew exactly where the second ball was going to land, and then Talbot gives possession away again. Mariners, it's their turn to awkwardly look for the right throw-in. Torres is the answer. Docker. Mikhail Docker frees his feet. This is Ballard, but De Pizio comes in to intervene. So Central Coast keep possession. Problem solving on the run out there. Here's Docker. Torres on the move. Jarkovic for company. Ballard. Torres surveys his options. Big work from Nisbet. Teammates treading on his toes here in Docker and Caputo. Central forward. Back helping out the defence, but Central Coast quickly regained possession. I don't know, Mossy, that seemed a bit disorganised. A number of players clustered around the ball, just trying to work out who's making the run and who's actually taking possession.
Yeah, I think they just kept the ball in a tight area for too long. One or two passes too many. They drew a lot of Melbourne City defenders into that area. That's when you want to come out of that area.
Plenty of breathing room here for Nuno Reich. Against driving the ball forward, leaves it with Talbot instead. Well, in this situation, Mossy, we'll wait and see what the result of this diagonal ball is. It's out for a throw-in. How much responsibility is on Ugarkovic or Arslan to actually come up and present for the ball, or are Melbourne City happy to keep it in that sort of territory and be very patient?
Oh, they'll probably be more patient. They've got the right to be a bit more patient than the Mariners, being the away team. As we saw early on, they had sustained possession, didn't really make any clear incisions in that first 5 minutes, and then started to get some good incisions down the right and left-hand side.
Caputo pressing and causing just a bit of a hurry-up once again, dealt with comfortably enough by Vukovic. Torres. To accelerate the pace of play. DiPizio not able to find a teammate and match him. City flashed through the right. Jakalic thought about the early ball. Now waits for the overlap. Ugarkovic. Jakalic. A deflected cross, and that makes it keeper's ball. Vukovic glad to get out there briskly, though, to catch it ahead of Caputo.
Well, it was the deflection that made it desperation stakes for Vukovic. First, I thought he was going to stay on his line, but then when it was deflected, it took a bit of the pace off the ball and he had to come for it and come smartly, which he did.
DiPizio has done well to draw a foul out of Antonis. And now, we wondered if there'd be some long memories. Well, Lopano's managed to just annoy his way into the book of Johnny Barrero there. And you saw him hold up three fingers, so I wonder if that is Barrero particularly policing, delaying the restart of play.
I think so, because the game's just got a little bit scrappy in the last 5 minutes. Part of the responsibility on a referee is to keep the game flowing. So I've got no problem with Jonathan Barrero livening things up a little bit.
So Lapane, a 19-year-old playing game number 39 tonight. We'll have to watch his step. He's the first player to receive a yellow card. Antonis found Ugarkovic. Ugarkovic can drive forward. Tried to thread the through ball. Intercepted, and now Nisbet. His first thoughts were to try and find a back pass, but Antonis went in and stripped him of the ball.
Well, it was another example of that run from Talbot from right fullback. A diagonal run inside to leave all the space outside him for Jakalic. Nearly ended up on the end of a killer pass. It wasn't to be. It's a clear tactic from Melbourne City.
Long ball from Curtis Good, right up the middle. Caputo controls on the chest. Twisting and turning away from Brian Kaltak. Now the clearance to the edge of the box. Antonis, his range. Kaltak leaps through. Vukovic not called into action. Terry Antonis lining up from anywhere outside the penalty area. Is enough to get the defence's heart rate pumping. Here is Antonis again, this time looking for a teammate with the cross. Fernandez getting forward. First time ball, loops across the penalty area. Jakalic returns it. Ping pong across the box, but it went out. Feels like one of these moves at breakneck speed might just come off, Mossy, and give us a spectacular goal if City can get the timing exactly right.
Yeah, that's the key, isn't it, as we see Terry Antonis here lining one up from outside the box, and you certainly wouldn't put it past him, but that's Mr. Perpetual Motion, Brian Kaltak. He just got done out in the wide area. He stuck true to his responsibility to get back central as quickly as possible. Got himself in the way of that Antonis shot.
Ballard. From defensive midfield, looking up at all 11 opponents from Melbourne City here. The defence slowly dropping back as Aaron has worked the left flank. Docker's touch lets him down. Mark Jackson shouting instructions. A draw helps neither team tonight. It would still leave Melbourne City 3 points off top six pace. For the Mariners, it would leave them 5 points behind the Wellington Phoenix. Safe to say that all the neutral parties watching on tonight, Mossy might prefer a draw as their result. Here's Arslan. Ugarkovic. Yakulish waited for the pass. The Mariners have packed the defensive penalty area. And Paul, well, with a sidestep that was nearly too clever by half, has been able to win a foul rather than concede a corner.
Just too many numbers in the end. The Mariners playing that back five tonight. With Paul, Kaltak and Hall as the three central defenders. Storm Roo and Mikhail Docker as the wingbacks.
The ball squeezes out once again. Well, if there is one neutral party who might prefer a win by either team, funnily enough, it's probably Melbourne Victory. They might like Melbourne City to win tonight just to keep the Central Coast Mariners within striking distance as they aim for second place and direct passage through to the semi-finals. Of course, that Melbourne derby this weekend will be absolutely vital to both City's top six hopes and Melbourne Victory's hopes of bridging the gap to the top two. A task that will be that much tougher if the Mariners do get all 3 points here tonight.
Well, you'd think the Mariners absolutely must get the 3 points tonight if they're to give themselves any chance of that Premier's plate, of course, hosting Wellington on the weekend in a massive, massive game. They've also got that AFC Cup to navigate.
A slip here from Kaltak. Caputo trying to capitalise. And Arslan hits the post. The width of the woodwork away from the opener for Melbourne City. And Kaltak is off the hook.
Absolutely, isn't he? It's not often you see him get caught in possession, but wisely leaving it for a player of Arslan's capability from that area. And he almost got the precision spot on, but for the woodwork. That's a warning shot fired right across the bow of Central Coast Mariners. They've dodged one there.
Melbourne City getting closer. Arslan, who scored two in the 7-0 win against Western Sydney Wanderers, which was a while ago now. It was the 12th of March, so it's been 3 weeks. Of course, we had the international break in there, so Melbourne City have played just the one game since the nil-all draw against Newcastle at the weekend. Now getting games back into the legs as a unit.
I think the other thing for the Mariners tonight, Tayo, is they need to rebound from that weekend performance and result against Sydney FC. Sydney FC were the better side on the night. The Mariners off their game. It was off the back of an international break. So it can't have been fatigue. It was just the way they came out of that break. It wasn't to that man's liking.
Contact. Shallow clearance, Antonis, only as far as Nisbet. Keeps good, finds a teammate. Sliced pass here from Talbot, asking a lot of Ugarkovic to keep it in. And nearly got a kind deflection off the shins. Finds the ball at the feet of his teammate, Antonis, instead. So City stay on the attack. Jakovic flips it into space. Ugarkovic made space well, and now Caputo blocked immediately by Dan Hall, who had to be on the scene to stop a shot on target.
Well, it's another good moment from Melbourne City down the right-hand side. Talbot making that run from right fullback again, creating the space for other players. Mugarkovic, we know that he makes late runs into the box from midfield. That's a half a chance for Caputo.
Downhill, one of the many defenders in the penalty area. As the corner goes outside the box to Turnus, who was blocked, and then Mugarkovic. Now the ball goes into the area. Paul, his man on the pitch, rises to the header. And Antonis. Curtis Good and Stephen Mugarkovic. Antonis was making a forward run. Aslan ignored that. Decides to switch to Fernandez. Mugarkovic just left a little shallow storm room. A full-blooded challenge. Guerrero reaches for the yellow card again. Pane, the man who was booked earlier in the game, this time on the end of a yellow card tackle.
Well, I can't agree with that. I think that's a good tackle from Storm Root. He studs it down. I think he gets good contact on the ball, plays it into the leg of Lapane. If it's a foul, which I don't think it is, I don't think in any way, shape or form should that have been a yellow card. Jonathan Barrero's got that one wrong.
Sent off just the once in his A-League men's career, and funnily enough, it was last time these two teams played back in January, so he's on notice. First Mariner in the book. Now a free kick in a dangerous position. We've seen one corner which was taken wide rather than into the box. Roof's still grumbling about being booked for that foul. Organised. Two in the wall. Toke Aslan with an acute angle to work. Aslan goes direct, and Vukovic saw it late. Able to claw it away initially, and then Nuno Reyes with the follow-up. That tumbles out for a goal kick.
Well, I'm surprised. There was a couple of defenders that looked like they ducked out of the way there. You can see maybe Edmondson. I think it was over his head, but Brian Kaltak, I think Danny Vukovic was expecting him to defend that. He saw it very late and did very well, because that's a strong left hand to palm the ball to safety.
39 years young, game 335. Oh, the Mariners are in trouble here. They've coughed up possession. Caputo and Vukovic on hand again. He's annoyed because that chance shouldn't have been coughed up. And he's able to save the day once more.
Well, it's just picking and choosing the right time to play out from the back. Melbourne City are well set to defend a short goal kick. Sometimes you just got to turn the opposition around, keep them guessing. We're seeing it more and more in modern football. If you overplay things, it's at your peril.
Short corner again comes unstuck to Pizzio. And the Mariners can clear. Not that far. Home fans restless as Antonis wins back possession with aggression. Caputo. Sitting well and truly on top territorially. Mariners just need to break the shackles. Nisbet. Edmondson. He is able to win a foul that will get the Mariners, relatively speaking, out of trouble. They're going to turn defence into attack in the blink of an eye. Edmondson away, dashing forward. Torres on his inside. Torres has to double back. City defence set in position. Docker, Nisbet. Dan Hall. Ballard rolled off Antonis. Saw Rue advancing through the right, the cut across. Ballard tried to manufacture a shot on the instep.
Well, he nearly finished what he started there, Max Ballard. Brilliant turn, real spatial awareness.
Now the tricks come out from Aslan. Quality back heel, Lapane. Robbed from the blind side. Nisbet came in like a pickpocket and stole the ball away. There's a bit of flow back to the game again. Teams countering on each other. Nisbet swings it out to the left. Docker is there. Is this the Mariners' moment? He's got two defenders to deal with. Mikael Docker fires the shot. DiPizio. Not able to bring the ball under his command as Reyes clears away.
DiPizio with half a challenge for a handball there. I don't think there was anything in it from first glance. But another good opening for the Central Coast Mariners. Here it is here, Docker with the shot. The hand's close to the body. I'm sure there is a little bit of contact there. But you can't say that the arm's not in a natural position.
Yeah, he's thighed it up into an arm that's tucked right in against his body. Nothing wrong with that. Sprung to life here just after the half hour mark. Ballard to take the corner. Plenty of tall targets to aim for. Paul, Kaltak, Edmondson. And Dan Hall. In comes the corner. Edmondson! Couldn't hit the target.
Well, it's a warning for Melbourne City. Way too much space for Edmondson inside that penalty box. It's Talbot that just falls away from Edmondson. He started to track his run, but he wasn't there for the contest.
Garkovic breaking into space. He's got Nisbet in hot pursuit. Coming in to help out. The pincer movement from Ballard won the ball away. Torres' nice work gave Nisbet possession. For the first time tonight, though, he's forced to do a U-turn and play it back to his defence. Ballard. Now Nisbet can face forward. Midfield to move in. Docker to his left, and that's where the ball goes. Mikhail Docker. Angel Torres, shooting range for him, opts for DiPizio, uses that left foot, and it catches a deflection behind for a corner kick.
He had no other thought in his mind, DiPizio, did he? Just to get that first touch out of his feet. To try and execute a left foot shot, it would have been a super strike from there to beat Jamie Young. As we see the ball played inside from Torres, there it is there. Catches the back of Nuno Raish. For another Mariners corner.
DiPizio, whose one goal was January the 27th against Brisbane, right here at Industry Group Stadium. Now, this is a concern, but perhaps not red alert for Jack Wyszorski, young Socceroo, who has played for the Australia under-20s, but is yet to make his A-League men's debut. Danny Vukovic getting the magic spray. Sure, I saw an injury or a collision that may have led to this, Mossy, but if you can be an amateur medic for me, what part of the upper shin or lower knee appears to be getting the attention?
I'm not sure if that's a lump we can see on the front of Vuka's knee. But certainly, you'd rather see the spray on the front of the leg than the back of the leg, because if it's on the back of the leg, it's more likely to be a soft tissue injury. This looks like an impact injury.
Body language never really suggested he was worried about having to come off Danny Vukovic, and indeed the signal to the bench suggests that after these running repairs he'll be all right to continue. Good time to take the treatment when your team's got an attacking corner down at the other end. So the last Mariners corner was met by an unmarked Edmondson. They find a header again. Edmondson lurks at the top of the box. Ballard's corner swings in. Jamie Young claws it away. Angel Torres drops the hammer on Lapane, but Lapane stayed goal side. Docker sweeps it over to Nisbet. Most of the Mariners' tools have stayed forward here. In comes the cross. Too much on it. And a missed opportunity.
Yeah, that's unfortunate for the Mariners. Ballard just looking to put too much on that ball. His corner delivery from the corner in the first instance was excellent. Jamie Young with a great fist under pressure.
Jankovic hard against the line, knew that Yakalish was making a run. Caputo advancing, headed away by Kaltak. Risky back pass, Paul. Back to Lisbon to run out into open space. Left back and take over possession. Ballard. DiPizio. Nisbet pushed as he played the pass. Antonis Let's see, it's the free kick. What have you made of Josh Nisbet's role so far tonight? At times he has had to double back and feed the ball to his defence rather than look to advance. It's all about finding a player in space who can face forward, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right, but he's such an efficient player on the ball, Josh Nisbet. Fully deserved his Socceroo cap. So delighted to see him take the field for the national team. See if he can take his game to another level now that he's had that experience.
Back here. Caputo's really made a presence of himself, the 18-year-old. Docker, who got the last touch. Just throwing is the call.
Well, he did the hard part so well, Edmondson, by nicking in and winning the ball and setting himself away on goal. Then he needed the composure. That was a rush of blood. He was never going to score from that angle.
Antonis.
At the very least, in that situation from Edmondson, you've got to go across the goalkeeper and at least force a save. Jamie Young can't get both hands to it. It might be parried into the path of another attacking player.
Demhol getting back into defensive position. City backwards all the way to their keeper from a second half throw in. Just trying to draw a few Mariners up the pitch, create some gaps. As you can see, central midfield pretty busy, so Antonis opts for the right. Yakalish, and now Talbot getting forward. Talbot cuts it back, no one home at the top of the box. It's really been such a reliable place for someone, Antonis or Arslan or anyone, to be there for Melbourne City this season, but there's no one home. Sure whether that was a blind or an instinctive pass there, but he just sent it to green grass and two opponents.
Yeah, that's right, and it actually, for one of a few times, showed the back five for the Mariners didn't quite work on that occasion, because that incisive run from Talbot from right fullback diagonally inside started to cause some problems on that occasion. Just picked the wrong pass at the end of it.
So here is take the game on single-handedly. Still going, pushes it through. Yakalish! Side netting. And he's still yet to double his season tally from just the one goal in the A-League so far this campaign.
Oh, and he had Steve Ugarkovic free as a bird in the middle there. He would have been onside as well had he laid the ball square. And if you don't lay the ball square, you have to hit the target. Great work from Arslan. Very creative and robust run to pick Yakalish out. But it's those decisions in those areas that make all the difference.
Of course, it was against the Mariners back on the 17th of December in the 3-all draw. Amy Park that he had scored his one and only A-League goal. Now Caputo's advancing through the right. A series of deflections, and it did appear to hit the midriff of Caputo last, before crossing the line, so Caltech avoids conceding a corner. So as we tick down to 5 minutes of regulation until half-time, Mossy, I know it's a bit of a cliche to call a nil-all game a fascinating tactical battle, but that's exactly what it's been. Who do you think is actually the happier of the two managers, given it's a must-win game for both?
Look, I think Melbourne City will go in a little bit happier than the Mariners. They just haven't quite found their rhythm. We spoke about their performance on the weekend against Sydney FC. It's just not the same free-flowing Mariners that we'd come to expect before the international break. They're not playing badly, not by any stretch. They just haven't quite found their rhythm, so I think the Melbourne City camp will be a touch happier.
Fernandez. Aslan, a solo run just a moment ago. Talbot, Ugarkovic rolls off Kaltak, and this time it is a corner. They're yet to send a conventional corner into the box, Melbourne City. They've sent them sideways or taken them short each time so far tonight. Tolgay Aslan will look for something different. Is it due to, surely not due to the height difference? It's not that big a difference, Mossy. Curtis Good, Yakulish, even Caputo, all capable of winning a header.
Yeah, look, the Melbourne City coaching staff will have pored over video after video of how the Mariners defend set pieces. So if they're going short, that's what they've spotted during the week as potentially a weakness in the way the Mariners defend.
This time we do get a conventional delivery, and it leads to a near post header. Leaning out from Fernandez. So the corner comes to naught. Napoli urging his team on. Will we get a goal before halftime? It could really change the complexion of this contest. The City have had long spells of territorial dominance, but the Mariners have shown they are capable of stinging. Angel Torres leading an attack now. Waiting for two defenders to commit. Ballard. Dan Hall. Now Kaltak, Ballard. Blind turn attempted from Mikhail Docker, and City take the ball away. Slight challenge came in from Hall, and then he's been wiped out by his own man, Storm Rue. Turned his ankle there. In the meantime, City will continue to move. Lapane. He's got a couple in the penalty area. Caputo leaves it. Yakulish! Deflected away, and it just won't go for Martin Yakulish. He can't believe it.
Well, he's in utter disbelief that that ball has not found the back of Danny Vukovic's net. As they break down the left-hand side, and it's Lapane who picks the pass. Great little step over in the middle from Caputo. And Yakulish, you just simply have to score from there. There is no real conviction behind that shot from Marin Yakulish. And he presents the opportunity for Danny Vukovic to make a fantastic save.
Not caught enough of Danny Vukovic to stay wide of the target. Even he had so much of the goal to aim for. It even could have deflected in off the keeper, but Vukovic got enough of a chunk of the ball to send it out for this resulting corner. Into the pack of play as it goes, and Kaltak wins the header. Ugarkovic, Kaltak off the chest. Now the Mariners can repel. Torres goes to ground in spectacular fashion, and even though Antonis protests that it was a dive, the free kick is given. He's done the Fosbury flop there, Mossy.
Yeah. No problem with that decision from our referee, Jonathan Barrero, but, gee, the anguish on the face of Ralph Napoli. I'm sure the anguish on the face of Aurelio Vidmar. Watching from afar. That chance to Yakulish. Could that just come back to haunt them?
Curtis Good here ushers the ball out for a goal kick. So we're down to 1 minute of regulation to go in the first half. The Melbourne City bench tonight. You see Jamie McLaren and Matthew Leckie, the two Socceroos, along with James Jago and Marco Tilio. It is a star-studded substitutes list for the visiting team tonight. Mariners have got no shortage of attacking weapons. Christian Theoharis, Alu Kwol, Jing Rees. No doubt some or many of these players will have a role to play. The Mariners subs currently warming up.
Mark Jackson's got some work to do at halftime. 60% possession to the visiting side. 9 attempts to 5 on target. 3 to 1 on target. There's some work to be done for the home side in the second half.
Some urgency here at the end of the first 45. Yakulish cuts it back. Talbot's got to commit. Out came Ballard. Antonis took over though. Lapane, a bender on his right foot. Cleared by Kaltak. Curtis Good went for a climb, and the whistle was in the mouth from Johnny Barrero as we tick into 3 additional minutes. At the end of what has been an entertaining game so far, it just needs a goal.
It has. It may not have had too much rhythm through midfield, but there's been chances at both ends. There's been some good moments of transition from both sides as well. Big, big save from Danny Vukovic.
Having played on Saturday, more or less an even amount of recovery coming into the game.
You'd have to give the Mariners the advantage there. Just a short trip back up the freeway compared to Melbourne. Having to travel.
Tapizio made the most of contact, but play continues. Torres loses two opponents in the blink of an eye. Sends the ball out wide. Sydney defensive midfield recovering. And Mel Torres wants to keep the attack moving. Oh, what a teasing cross. That didn't quite have the bend to get back to Stormroo.
Almost a brilliant attack from the Mariners. That man there, Angel Torres, right at the heart of it. Linking up with Edmondson down the left-hand side. He sees the run from Roo. Just can't quite wrap his toe around it to get enough bend on it to find his right wing back.
Showing a spark as we tick down to the last minute of three additional at the end of the first half. They'll have to throw in here as well. Kaltak. This is Torres to present for the ball. The flick pass on Nunaresh. Yankalish determined to make amends for a couple of chances spurned. Fernandez. Tonga Aslan attracts a crowd wherever he goes. It's the better of Docker, but Dan Hall got a foot in.
Looks like he ran out of legs and real estate. In one motion there, Aslan. He's been working hard. His first 47 or so minutes.
Danny Vukovic will be keen to manage the clock here and perhaps get Central Coast to halftime. Tick, tick. That'll be the end of three additional minutes. And it is indeed met by the halftime whistle. I can tell you these two teams haven't played a nil-all draw since January 2014, when Melbourne City was still known as Melbourne Heart. Not for a lack of trying, they are yet to find the back of the net tonight. Hopefully, we're not heading for a more in a decade first. These two teams are entertainers, and they just haven't found the goal-scoring touch so far. Plenty of firepower on both benches, no doubt will be unleashed in the second 45. But for now, it's Central Coast Mariners nil, Melbourne City nil. Stay with us here on Paramount Plus. We'll be back for the halftime show on the other side of this short break.
Maybe a victim from the debut. The A-League's Professional Footballers Australia and Football Coaches Australia are taking a stand against online bullying in Australian football. There is no place for racism, abuse or hate in our sport. Play fair. Players are illegal at our meetings. If you possess sport role player, there are severe penalties that apply. Any spectator identified with a prohibited item may be refused entry, evicted from the stadium, potentially banned from attending future matches, and handed over to police for further questioning. A financial fine will also be issued. We ask you to respect your fellow spectators by refraining from illegal and dangerous activities.
Every match is crucial in the countdown to the Olympics. Don't miss the Matildas against Mexico. That's right, 9:30 a.m. on Wednesday, Australian Eastern Standard Time. Let's get into the Hungry Jacks halftime show for this game, which is currently Central Coast 0, Melbourne City 0. But Phil Moss, it probably shouldn't be, given the quality of chances that have been created.
Yeah, that's right. I think Danny Vukovic has been one of the best players in the first half, and that says that Melbourne City have had their opportunities, have had two big chances, particularly that one to Marin Jakalic late on that he should have buried. There's no doubt about that, but work to do for the home side in the second half.
Let's get into the Harvey Norman highlights then and take a look at those chances to score for both of these teams. And so we start, Mossy, with Melbourne City. I thought that a lot of their attacking players had flashes and moments in the first half. And on this occasion, it was Terry Antonis' opportunity to get forward.
That's right. We know he can score spectacular goals from out there. Brian Kaltak getting his body in the way. But again, this is Brian Kaltak. That's very uncharacteristic from him to get caught in possession. And Arslan, the width of the post away from giving his side the lead.
Moore City, they were territorially dominant at times. And the runs from midfield and the defenders getting forward were able to just create havoc, mainly through that right channel, it must be said. Mariners, though, on the occasions they did go forward, Mossy, they were able to show us what they were capable of.
Yeah, great awareness from Max Ballard in midfield there where the space is, and he nearly finishes it with a very cute finish from the Stormroo delivery into the box. And this one from the corner, this was a free header to Edmondson, and Callum Talbot had lost his man there. And here's Arslan, this is the chance. Great chance here as he bursts through the Mariners' defence and finds Jakalic. And you've got to hit the target there because he had Ugarkovic free on the penalty spot if he cut the ball back. And here's the biggest chance in the first half. Lapane, great step over from Max Caputo. And Jakalic just has to bury that. He cannot give Danny Vukovic the opportunity to pull off what was a very important save, but it was harder to miss than it was to score.
What do the underlying numbers tell us about this nil-nil? Not a shock that City are ball dominant, but is there anything there that suggests the Mariners can flip at least the territory battle in the second half?
Well, there is, and it's their form this season. They weren't great against Sydney FC on the weekend, but other than that, in the first four games of the season, they've been irrepressible, really, and we know that they can turn it on in the blink of an eye. So despite those expected goals, the Mariners will be dangerous right until the final whistle.
So here's a look at the Mariners dressing room at present, and the man, Danny Vukovic, who has been at the star of the first half so far, Mossy. It has to be said that without him, this game would definitely have had a goal so far.
Yeah, great save from Yakalish, of course, but also a big, big left hand to a free kick from Arslan that was so critical in that first half, and his leadership is always a critical part of what the Mariners put out.
So let's take a look at the Paramount Plus Player Index. It'll be absolutely no shock to you that Danny Vukovic is top of the rankings so far. Angel Torres has been one of the prime movers this season, as has Tolga Arslan, but they're all pretty low numbers, Mossy. Look at that big gap, 81 to 69 between Vukovic in second place.
Yeah, well, some crucial saves, as we just spoke about, and the way he's marshalled his troops. Maybe played out once too often in that first half when Melbourne City was set for the press, but he's such a critical component of this Mariners team.
Good to see the youngster Max Caputo up there as well. He's had a couple of shots in the game, but not been able to double his season tally of just the one goal so far, the 18-year-old. Let's have a look at some of Danny Vukovic's finest work in this half. That was a late reaction there when his defence didn't go for him, but some of the other saves were very much his responsibility from moment one.
Yeah, that's right. I think that free kick from Arslan, maybe he was expecting Caltech to attack the ball, but he's just ever present. He's a big, big presence in between the sticks for the Mariners. And here's a save off Yakalish. I still think that Yakalish just has to bury that. I don't think he can give Vukovic the chance to save it, but he does, and the Mariners custodian was up to the task.
Now, tonight's a Tuesday game. Don't forget the Isuzu Ute A-League continues at midweek tomorrow night, and it is another absolutely vital game. It's going to be Perth Glory taking on Sydney FC. Mossy, this was Perth at the weekend. They were defeated 2-1 by Melbourne Victory at Amy Park. But Daniel Benny, the 17-year-old in his debut season, was able to score a goal. Sydney FC are in imperious form, though. And even though they're going west, I think they start this one as a fairly warm favourite.
Yeah, I think they do. It's a tough place to go. We all know that. But Sydney FC were very good on the weekend against the Mariners, as we're seeing here. But also Melbourne Victory were good on the weekend against Perth. So Perth will be looking to rebound from that. But Sydney FC, as you say, go in as favourites.
What's the key to Perth getting a result here? I know that midweek game in Perth is a pretty tough challenge for any team. But is there something from Perth that they can do to Sydney FC to try and spring a surprise?
Well, concentration in defence and then effectiveness with the ball going forward. I mean, stating the obvious, but I think it's those little moments that are letting Perth down defensively, where they're making mistakes and letting opponents score goals against them. And then going forward, they've just got to have that belief that they can score goals, which they can.
Don't miss it tomorrow night. That's been your Hungry Jacks halftime show. Second half just around the corner. And don't forget, coming up in the very near future, the Scottish Cup is on Paramount Plus. Don't miss it.
Thanks to Aaron Fair. Welcome back to the field, your Central Coast Mariners.
New faces and perhaps new energy for the Central Coast at the start of the second half. Aluqual, one of a triple substitution that the home team Mariners are making to try and improve on a nil-all scoreline. There's Bradley Tapp. He'll come on for his 11th career appearance. And along with Aluqual and Christian Theoharis, that's the triple change for Central Coast. The three players making way are Nathan Paul, Miguel DiPizio and Ryan Edmondson. Phil Moss rejoins me here in the commentary booth. Mossy, what do you make of the Mariners pulling a triple change at the halftime break?
Yeah, well, we'll wait and see what that means tactically, and it may mean that Mark Jackson's decided to go to back to a back four. It was a back five in the first half. And of course, with Aluqual and Christian Theoharis, he gets a goal scorer and he gets some creativity as well, fresh legs. Good reaction from the Mariners coach, because they didn't have things all their own way in that first half. Melbourne City really should have gone into the break leading.
It was 60-40 possession, and the territory battle was very much skewed Melbourne City's way as well. The Mariners kick off the second half scoreless in this grand final rematch at present. A draw doesn't help either team a great deal. It would leave Melbourne City 3 points adrift of the top six. It would leave the Central Coast Mariners 5 points behind the Wellington Phoenix, who would have a big up, not just for these two teams, but for plenty of interested onlookers all up and down the table in the Isuzu Ute League men's. Melbourne City, no changes to their first half team. As we see Stephen Ugarkovic here taking possession. And now Yakulis attempting a back heel. First touch for Tapp off the bench. Possession immediately yielded back to Antokas. Now Fernandez. A touch from Alessandro Lapane. Tonga Aslan trying to cut around. And now brings Fernandez back into play. Veers away from Mikhail Docker. And the teams that are out on the pitch will be appearing at the base of your screen. As you can see, Storm Roo picked up a yellow card in the first half. Alessandro Lapane, the only other player in the book. Here's Terry Antonis. Slides it to Max Caputo on the tight angle, cutting it across. Vital clearance from Dan Hall. Aslan. Now Fernandez whips in a ball and headed away by Kaltak. Ball with a little flick, but the Mariners just can't find possession.
No, it's similar to the way Melbourne City started the first half. Good possession, building some pressure. And the Mariners have gone to that back four with Storm Roo moving across to left back. Docker at right back, Bradley Tapp in midfield next to Max Ballard with Josh Nisbet pushing forward to play in behind Quall. So Mark Jackson wasting no time with those subs and a tactical tweak.
Heard the clash of boot on shin guard there, and now a lock of arms. Christian Theoharis causing trouble and able to win himself a foul off Vicente Fernandez.
There's some of the creativity, technical ability of Theoharis. He's drawing a foul for his side.
Free kick came to Little. Immediately at the other end, Kaltak is required to intervene. Jakalish, Kaltak again, the obstacle that Melbourne City can't pass. Nisbet, caught in two minds about where to go. Just got raked across the back of his ankles there to give away a foul. And now, space to exploit. Theoharis can turn and go. He's got options left, right and centre. Docker's his option. Mikhail Docker whips it across. And Kaltak with safety first, sends it behind for a corner kick.
Good sweeping move from the Mariners. Theoharis finding himself in acres of space in a pocket in midfield. Turned and drove at the Melbourne City defence.
Corner initially headed away, and then Nisbet concedes ground. Danny Bukovic lured well out of his penalty area here, but has Kaltak open. Kaltak with a drifting pass. Jakalish wants his own keeper here. Jamie Young. Curtis Good strides out of defence. Vicente Fernandez. Pass quarter deflection off Theoharis. He's making things happen out there, Theoharis. First time ball. A little ambitious this time. With the flick header on, Ugarkovic's early ball. Kaltak has given possession away. Caputo took it off him. The cut across, and there's the goal for Togai Aslan. Created by the forward press of Max Caputo, and Togai Aslan makes it Melbourne City 1, Central Coast Mariners 0.
And you can't deny them the lead, Melbourne City. They're good value for that. Brian Kaltak again with an uncharacteristic mistake. Just looking a little bit sluggish tonight. The big defender on the Harvey Norman replay, getting caught in possession for the second time this evening. Max Caputo not losing belief that he could win that ball and then putting it on a platter for Tolgay Arslan to give Melbourne City a deserved lead.
Mikhail Docker was right there on his case but couldn't stop the tap-in for goal number 9 of the campaign for Tolgay Arslan. And weekend frustrations set aside, and he almost summoned the 18-year-old Caputo to say, come over and celebrate with me. And look at that, Jakalish, just an outpouring of relief with his coach, Ralph Knapp.
Yeah, that'll be a huge relief to Melbourne City. So I think they would have gone into the break wondering what they had to do to score. Now they've got one in the first 5 minutes of the second half. But again, often you see Brian Kaltak caught in possession. That's twice tonight. The first one nearly led to a goal. The second one did.
Theoharis failed here. So the Mariners had already made a triple change at halftime. And if anything, in an attacking sense, those changes were just starting to bear fruit. So they cough up a goal. A mistake and a bit of Melbourne City attacking intent is able to find the opener, but it might just crack this game open. Max Ballard looking for the instant response, but he drove it straight at Jamie Young.
Well, it's a good response. It's a response you'd expect from the Mariners. not going into their shell, getting forward, chance on goal. Max Ballard, we know, can strike the ball. But he is an imposing figure between the posts for Melbourne City, Jamie Young. It's going to have to be a special one from that distance.
City want to double their lead. I feel as though they've got reward for their efforts and perhaps 90 minutes of pent-up frustration from the nil-all draw against Newcastle at the weekend off the chest as well. Nuno Reyes's long ball. Yakalish trying to veer in from the wing, and it was a goal, but again from Kaltak, and Danny Vukovic cleverly waited for the ball to enter the penalty area before collapsing on.
You can't bottle experience. Danny Vukovic showed plenty of it in that situation.
Talbot keeps the ball away from Angel Torres. Press is on here. Theoharis goes to ground. Penalty, get it! Christian Theoharis has come on with intent to make things happen. And after catching Fernandez in possession, he's won the Mariners a penalty.
Will you buy your own luck in this game? Christian Theoharis, as you rightly pointed out, Teo, the press was absolutely key here. Look at the pressure he puts on the ball. He gets himself in the tangle. And referee Jonathan Barrero, with no doubt but to point to the penalty spot, to give the Mariners a chance to get themselves back into this game.
So Fernandez, the culprit there, after being caught in possession. A bit of verbal going on in the aftermath for Curtis Good and Christian Theoharis, but Angel Torres has got to set himself here. If he strikes truly, it'll be goal number 12 of the campaign. Jamie Young waits on the line. Big moment in the match. He's taken two this season, only scored the one. Angel Torres! Mariners level in the blink of an eye. And Angel Torres' 12th of the season brings Central Coast level in this must-win game.
Super sub, Theoharis was the architect. Angel Torres, the executioner from the penalty spot. Great retort from the Central Coast Mariners after going behind only a few minutes ago. As we see on the Harvey Norman replay, Angel Torres, so confident from 12 yards, dispatches it with some aplomb. He's got his teammate Christian Theoharis coming off the bench to thank for that. The intensity of his press on Fernandez got the defender looking up straight away with the ball at his feet, and that pressure led to the penalty itself.
They must be sick of the sight of him. Five head-to-head, a hat-trick earlier in the campaign at Amy Park, the match-winning goal back in January. And look at that, that's the all-time list. It's only his third appearance against them, Mossy, and he's already gate-crashed the top three.
Oh, he's been a wonderful player this season, Miguel Torres. Once he found his feet early on, I thought he was struggling to come to grips with the A-League. But once he got his rhythm, he's been a wonderful player.
Half-time subs, Alu Kwal, sore, but not staying down. He's back to his feet. In the meantime, free kick Central Coast. And any momentum that Melbourne City may have had from taking the lead appears to have evaporated.
Well, after going into the break scoreless in this fixture, I said earlier the last 11 games between these two teams at Industry Group Stadium.
Torres. Blocked away by Good. Sliced high by Talbot. Danger not yet averted. Ballard's header goes sideways. Yakalish. And Kaltak with the clearance.
We'll just go back to that stat. Well, we've got a break in play. Last 11 at Industry Group Stadium between these two sides. Both teams have scored in each of those games an average of 4 goals per game during that 11-game stretch. All of a sudden, both teams have scored, Teo.
They have. I mean, there was a reason it had been more than 10 years since they last were in the Law Mosky. So we didn't have to wait long. First 10 minutes of the second half, both teams find the back of the net. And Ralph Napoli, who have been desperately hoping for a clean sheet and the first win after that Tolgay Arslan goal, it's a whole new game now.
Well, it is, and the blood pressure would have gone to a whole new level because it's the first 5 minutes after you score that's the most dangerous, as we know. Melbourne City giving away a penalty like that, which was all of their own doing. Credit to Theo Harris for the press, of course. That rips your heart out when you work so hard to take the lead and you give one away within that first 5 minutes.
Miscommunication here. Tarbert and Yapalism, it's just starting to fray. You can see Ralph Napoli and Scott Jamieson on the City bench are trying to keep spirits high. Body language of the teammates is not good.
It's high stakes. Pressure's on. You need to stay in touch with that top six. The point, as you said earlier, is probably no good.
How long will Melbourne City wait before they turn to the bench? Sprints going on behind the goal of the right screen for some of the subs, so perhaps the finishing touches before they come on. In the meantime, Talbot and the assistant referee, Andre Giev, is flagging because he was fouled here by Angel Torres.
Well, it's a silly foul to give away from Torres. He didn't need to go to ground. He didn't need to commit. He could have just gone with Talbot's run. He got his body between the ball and his goal. It's there where he dives in. No need. Talbot was running out of real estate as it was. Has given Melbourne City a free kick in a dangerous area.
Tony Arslan has one. Can he turn provider here?
Why?
First head Melbourne City. Curtis Good not able to keep it down. Tough to do anything with. Right at the peak of his leap, he met the ball. Turns to the centre of defence. Danny Vukovic goes for distance on the goal kick. Qual, shaken off that knock from a moment ago as he leaps into the night sky. Mikhail Docker. And now Theo Harris. Feigns to shoot. Can't quite sidestep Vukovic though. Now the City defence sitting deep in the penalty area with the midfield right on top. Cut back here from Stormrue, can't find a yellow shirt. Antonis, Curtis Good. Now Fernandez, the player who gave away the penalty. Calms down just for a moment. It allows Jamie Young to roam out of his penalty area. Tap. Rue. Arsla. So we've crossed the hour mark. 1-1 the score. Big final 30 minutes coming up. City big guns all remain on the bench for now, but for how long? Vukovic tries to catch out Stormrue by veering around him, but Rue and Kaltak had awareness, and now Tap, composed under pressure, is passed though, deflected into a dangerous area. Took a deflection off Lapane and then cleared away by Mikhail Docker. Theoharis sold the contact, but the referee wasn't buying. And now the cross is met. What a good chance for Melbourne City. It was a brilliant ball in from Antonis. And Marin Jakulic, the ball continues to follow him in the penalty area, but he shoots wide.
What a ball from Terry Antonis here with his left foot. Just floats it into a perfect area for Marin Jakulic to attack it. And he almost does everything right, Jakulic. Stormrue might have just done enough to put the Melbourne City winger off his strike on goal, but a great chance nonetheless.
Protestations continue in the aftermath of that shot going wide, but we're going to see some changes.
And here comes the penalty again. You can see there, look at that press from Christian Theoharis. Hasn't he made a difference coming off the bench at halftime? That intensity just led to the mistake from Fernandez and the goal to the Mariners.
So a double change. Two Socceroos, Matt Leckie and Marco Tilio come on. Alessandro Lapane and Martin Jakulich come off. And so Tilio, again, hit by injury in recent times, is able to come on and get some valuable minutes here. Can he be a game changer for Melbourne City? They've needed the finishing touch. We know that Matthew Leckie absolutely has that. First call of duty, though, is to defend, and that's exactly what Curtis Good is doing. So it's just Tilio's fourth appearance of the season. And his first appearance in the A-League since the 24th of February. And he did score against Sydney FC. Can they bring him into the play right here? Fernandez, dispossessed by the challenge of Theoharis. Now Docker, bit of a hospital pass. Tonga Arslan was right there, and Theoharis, while he was trying to win a foul, from the moment that ball left his teammate's foot.
Yeah, again, Theoharis using his experience there to draw the foul, take the pressure off his team.
Tap, really risky pass, had to execute. Dan Hall made it work. And he misses his mark, trying to get out of the defensive half. But City will go backwards themselves here and at least allow the pressing attackers to stretch their legs and go for a jog. Trying to press Jamie Young. Big aerial duel. Tilio's first touch is a header. Straight to Caltap. Through Nuno Reis. Tap. Rue left the ball with Tap, cleverly. Now Nisbet just had his ankle dragged there by Antonis.
They've certainly looked a lot more comfortable in the second half, despite Melbourne City taking the lead, the Mariners. I think you've got to pay some credit to Mark Jackson for going to a back four at half-time, making that triple substitution. Looking for ways to help his team find that rhythm.
Interesting stat, the duels in the second half. Mariners winning the 50-50 balls, but on this occasion, Fernandez is in at the feet of Mikhail Docker to clear away.
What a ball that was from Brian Kaltak. He fairly laced that all of 85, 90 metres. Brilliant switch of play.
Nisbet has to go chasing his own touch. The pressure from Ugarkovic was good, and he's fouled Tolga Arslan in his earnestness to go and chase the ball.
He just loses control of this. He turns into a touch tackle situation, Josh Nisbet, which you don't often say that about the diminutive Central Coast Mariners midfielder. Usually so technically good. Maybe just a little bit of fatigue creeping in.
So a mid-range free kick. Dan Vukovic is still establishing how many he wants in the wall and where. He's asked for three. Tommy Arslan, here are his numbers. And he's just keeping things ticking over. Let's not forget he did hit the post in the first half. Here's the free kick. I'll tell you what, Matthew Leckie had a bit of a run at the ball there, but it just didn't fall kindly for him to swing his right foot at it.
A bit of variation there from Antonis. You can see the eyes have it. He knows what he's looking for. Leckie makes that run. Kaltak does enough to defend the situation.
Pressing. Mariners looking for ways through. Tap has to go back to Kaltak. The way to his keeper, Vukovic. And the outlet was Mikhail Docker. And he sets Theoharis a task. Fernandez leads him to the ball, but it's awkward again, these two. We already saw them once in the half where Theoharis was able to nick in. This time all's well that ends well for Melbourne City. Garkovic has possession in midfield. And he sweeps it out to Marco Tilio. Let's see what he can do. Talbot storming forward. Tilio missed him with the pass. Just not on the same wavelength. And now the Mariners can start from midfield. Ballard to Nisbet. see a double change. Jamie McLaren and Jimmy Jago are coming on here. Terry Antonis's number is up. And the youngster, Max Caputo. So a couple of like-for-likes. Although I suspect that Jago will bring a different dimension to the City midfield. McLaren, his job is simple. Come on and score.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Melbourne City have just reeled out the heavy artillery, all the experience. Let's come on. Lecky, Tilio, McLaren, Jago. Not a bad bunch of subs to call on.
Tap keeps the ball in, and the Mariners on the attack. Qual went to ground. Curtis Good sweeps it away. So Central Coast retain possession. Three changes from the Mariners, four from Melbourne City now, so very different looking teams to the ones that were drawing nil all in the first half. Here is Jago. Ugarkovic just waited for the ball. Torres nearly robbed him, but it's with Tilio here. Ugarkovic straining to get to the return pass. Has he done enough to win a corner? He has.
Very good defending from Bradley Tapp. Coming from midfield, he really had the track. His opposite numbers run. He sticks to his guns very, very well. Defensive situation.
So a corner kick for Melbourne City. Fernandez, the left footer, takes it. Caltac rises high. Look at it on by Angel Torres, but he hasn't got a teammate out there for help. Garkovic. To go back to Jago. Arslan. Saw the run of Lecky. Mikhail Docker wins the initial header, and now Lecky trying to use his strength. He used it illegally, says the referee.
Well, you said the instructions for Jamie McLaren would have been very clear coming off the bench. His coach tonight, Ralph Napoli. Statistics are there to be broken. McLaren, J-Mac hasn't scored a goal in his last four A-League men's games against the Mariners. Before that, he had 12 games in his previous nine, including two hat-tricks.
Talbot goes in on Torres, and he's quick to apologise here. It's an interesting block tackle sort of situation. And the referee did see a foul, and Talbot's doing all the right things. Apologises to the ref, apologises to his fallen opponent. Mossy, your read?
Well, I'm looking at that and I'm comparing it to the Storm Roo challenge in the first half where Roo picked up the yellow card. Not seeing a lot of difference. I think that one was okay as well. Different story if you're sliding in from behind or your studs are raised. If you're using the conditions to slide in, play the ball off the attacker's leg, different story.
Very similar angle to the free kick Melbourne City had in the first half too, but this time Torres wants an outswinging free kick. Headed away by Nuno Reis. Tap left to go and retrieve as we tick into the final 20 minutes with the score tied 1-1. Tilio. Reis. Garkovic brings the ball under his command. Has to turn away from Nisbet. Fernandez able to get around Theoharis. And he wins a free kick too. He's getting some of his own back now, Vicente Fernandez. After giving away the penalty, and he's been left rolling here by Alu Qual.
Yeah, it's the right decision. Alu Qual just plays across the legs of Fernandez to win the ball back illegally. He knows he's in a game tonight, Fernandez.
Physicality of it all written across his face. He's back on his feet. Garkovic not so lucky. Jago. Arslan. He's got Ballard wearing him closely. Garkovic and now Talbot getting forward. And again, you see the frustration. Melbourne City set such high standards for themselves. When you see a misplaced pass or players making the wrong run, it really sticks out, doesn't it, Mossy?
It does, but I'm not sure what Arslan's so upset about. He was asking for a pinpoint delivery from Ugarkovic, I think, and I believe Ugarkovic played the right option, which was wide to Talbot. And then the next pass was for Arslan, but he'd stopped his run.
Bit of ducks and drakes there with the very short goal kick from Dan Hall and Danny Vukovic. Melbourne City did indeed press. And now we see a no-nonsense clearance. Quab protected the ball.
Very, very well under pressure too.
Nisbet's got the crowd rising. Fernandez trying to stick with him. Nisbet creates separation. Ballard. Now Docker. Nisbet tried to find a gap. Maybe the long shot was on there, but I think his mindset was entirely to pass over shoot. And Melbourne City can repel. Here's Lecky. Matt Lecky sends it central. Tonga Arslan. And now Tilio, he got the shot away. He was under heavy attention from Storm Roo, and it took the sting out of his attempt.
And it might have put the sting in his knee as well. Those ones can hurt. Arslan, I think, just leaves this a touch short for Tilio. You can see the block tackle from Storm Roo just on contact with the ball from Tilio.
So both players are a little proppy, but they're up without the need for the trainer to be called. Storm Roo, if you've joined us late, came into tonight wearing that head bandage already.
Got through a mountain of work tonight, Storm Roo. On the right-hand side is a wing-back in the first half. So left full-back in the second half. Always gives a good shift for his side.
Vicente Fernandez makes way for Harry Politidis. 21-year-old, comes on for just his 10th A-League Men's appearance. And Fernandez, I think perhaps the toll of playing at the weekend and then again midweek is just starting to add up on him. We saw it with some of the physicality, and perhaps this game is only going to be stretched more and more, Mossy. So the young legs of Politidis coming.
Well, it's perfectly poised, isn't it? 74 minutes gone. Both teams desperate for 3 points tonight. The draw does neither any real good. So strap yourselves in. Should be a wonderful final 15 or so minutes plus injury time.
Arslan from distance and catching practice for Danny Vukovic.
I think that was somewhere between a shot and a cross from Arslan. He had two willing runners on the back post.
Torres just coughs the ball up. Talbot. Leaves it with Tilio. Curtis Good comes forward, presses into midfield. Lecky, the new man, Harry Politidis.
Mariners with all 11 behind the ball, defending in that deep block, waiting for their moment to hit Melbourne City in transition.
Tilio trying to slay them through, and then he went for glory, but that was a very ambitious attempt, and it didn't have the right direction. Here's the live ladder, Mossy. This is what a draw does. It leaves Wellington 5 points clear on top from the same number of games played. It leaves Melbourne City outside the top four, the top six by a game. Quad, Theoharis, well won.
And there's the danger that Alu Quad possesses. Getting in behind with a great run, burst of speed, delivers a really telling pass. Theoharis just couldn't get his toe round that to get it on target. Good opening for the home side.
Docker's header. Let's see how indecisive Melbourne City were from that throw-in. Yielded possession immediately. Tap. Guillaume. He's going to run all the way up to the keeper. Ball's there to be one in the air. Good, crashed in on the much shorter Theoharis. And now it spills to Jego and Tolga Aslan. And here's Leckie. Spins onto his right foot. Tilio brings it down. Across, McLaren was rising. Ballard was company in the air. Docker, a little risky. The ball was running out of juice right against the byline, but he did enough to shield it out for a goal kick.
Oh, he used every roll of the ball then, Docker, didn't he? Hoping to get over the touchline, the byline, I should say. And there you go. That tells a bit of a story as well. Touches in opposition box. Melbourne City well ahead of the Mariners. Only one goal to show for it.
Dan Hall plays the pass. Max Ballard. Ball's got stuck between his feet and he fell out of the way. He's back in on Aslan but can't dispossess him. Resch. Tilio starting to become a focal point of the City attack. Skips inside. Cuts it across. Couldn't attack to Yugarkovic. And now a long ball release. Cole with it all to do. And that's good backtracking work. Harry Politidis. Talbot goes for the long ball. Counter heads away. Napoli really showing the tension of the game. Tilio, two career goals against the Mariners in what is now 9 head-to-head appearances. It's already. Chested the ball down, but the Mariners took it away. Nisbet. Mikhail Docker is motoring. Puts it back in for Josh Nisbet. And he bides his time. Angel Torres. His penalty drew the game level. To deal with him, Leckie with a shot of strength wins the ball away. Jego. Now Ugarkovic. Tick towards the final 10 minutes of regulation. Tilio taking on Rue. And now McLaren, is he being thread through? Oh, counter awkwardly went to ground early and had no option but to concede the corner.
See, that was a very early decision to go to ground from Caltac. Great weight on the pass from Marco Tilio. And they both end up on the floor. Caltac with his body in between J-Mac and the ball.
So City did have a corner from this side of the pitch earlier in the half, 6-3 for the night. They capitalise here, Tolga Aslan. It moves slowly through the air and is plucked out by Danny Vukovic. He's falling out of the way as they jockeyed for position, but ultimately the goalkeeper had it all the way. Shazam handball here. Assistant referee had a good view. Play continues. Theoharis dragged his pass, though. Thread through Nisbet. Interception made by Talbot. Ugarkovic looks up at Tap and takes him on. Presses it through for Aslan. And now Tilio. Aslan keeps it moving. Ugarkovic taken off his toes by Hall. The follow-up. Harry Politidis stings the fingertips of Danny Vukovic. And the youngster from distance nearly had his first A-League goal, but Vukovic is having a good night.
Oh, it's a really good strike, technically. And Vuka would have seen that late through bodies, even with a deflection off Theoharis as well. Great power behind the strike from Harry Politidis.
Now the corners from this right side are starting to add up. Arslan, an out swinger, and the Mariners have the answers in the air again. Ball this time gets the header away. Line of Mariners players at the edge of the box, and Kaltak is ordering them to press out. And the formation is restored somewhat, but Melbourne City have the ball.
Well, I know one party that will be sitting back watching this, rubbing their hands together tonight, and that's Wellington Phoenix. Chief Adam Griffiths and his staff and all the players.
Tilio, Politidis, McLaren! And that was nearly the end of his four-game drought against the Mariners, an opponent that he has loved scoring against so often. Vukovic had good position. Docker in the blink of an eye. Mariners into the attacking half. Theoharis. A little bit of untapped pace, and into the box he goes. Docker deflected away by Nuno Resch. And Jamie Young just wanted to make sure it wasn't falling on target.
Oh, how good's that from Theoharis? He just lulls the defender in a false sense of security and then hits the afterburners. We see the other end, Jamie McLaren's chance. Didn't get the purchase on it, but here Theoharis really lights it up for the Mariners. Plays it into the path of Docker, and I think that touch from Nuno Resch is crucial. I'm not sure if Jamie Young would have had that covered.
So a late corner for the Central Coast. He's so good in the air defensively. Can Max Ballard find one of his teammates here? High to the far post it goes, and is allowed to bounce in the box. A little half volley up, and the improvised attempt from Kwong. Doing his best impression of Zlatan Ibrahimovic there. And he sends it just over the bar.
Well, that was almost spectacular from Alu Kwong. Melbourne City just didn't deal with it. Alu Kwong, I'm not sure he had any other option but that one there, and it was going to be spectacular. Couldn't find the space for an overhead kick, couldn't face the target, so he used his heel.
Mariners goal scorer Angel Torres, he can clearly see he's disappointed to be leaving the game. Of course, he scored right here in the 88th minute back in January to win that match 2-1 against Melbourne City for the Central Coast, but his number is up after goal number 12 of the season. And on comes Jing Rees. He has three goals to his name this campaign, the 20-year-old. You can see he's immediately quick as a flash, looking to make his mark. As the ball finds its way back to Jamie Young, a little sidestep, drags it onto his right foot. Can't find a teammate with the pass, though. Pressure remains on for the Central Coast. Theoharis, first time we've really seen him over on the left side of the pitch.
Well, that's right, the introduction of Jing Rees. Just wonder if that means a shift for Theoharis to the left-hand side permanently. This last 5 minutes plus injury time. He's been so effective on the right-hand side, Theoharis.
Vukovic, Kwong. Can't get the better of Curtis Good. And in spite of how disappointed Angel Torres was there to be subbed off, Mossy, 3 games in 8 days, including another vital one this weekend, you can understand why Mark Jackson isn't going to let him completely run himself into the ground.
Yeah, that's right. You can understand the player being disappointed as well. He'd be thinking that he's a good chance of scoring the winner for his side. Coaches have the big picture in mind when they make these decisions. Mariners going to a 4-4-2 with Nisbet pushing out on that right-hand side.
It's hit the chest of Rue there, and so that's what drew the keeper out. Last touch off Tilio, though, so keeper and defender managed to avoid giving up the corner kick. Paramount Plus player in next. Tolga Arslan's taking the lead over Danny Vukovic. And you see there a big gap to third place. We'll revisit the Paramount Plus player index in the post-game show. Here's Lecky. He's never scored against the Mariners in his career. 10th appearance against them here tonight. And we'd love to tick them off his list and win this game for Melbourne City. Nuno Resch. Tilio. Waiting for the overlapping run. Talbot, and now the connection is there with Leckie. It's blocked away.
Well, the game is certainly hanging in the balance. It's there for the taking for either side. Certainly both benches have had an influence over this game, as you'd hope, for both coaches' sake.
Tilio, and Vukovic had to be sharp and double back because that goes down as a shot on target.
And I'm sure Marco Tilio would have claimed it had it found the back of the net as well. I think the intention was to cross the ball. Ended up being a shot on target.
Docker waited for Nisbet to make a run. Politidis extracted the ball away from him. Jago, City on the move. Arslan, and now Leckie. With the pace of McLaren, and the through ball was fed, but Dan Hall and Brian Kaltak combined to stop its progress. And now Jing Reese, able to out-muscle Talbot, and the Mariners could be away. Just behind Quall. To his advantage, and the chance to counter dissipates. 2 minutes of regulation to go. A goal now, either way, could be season shaping for these two teams. Jamie Young. Now Nunaresh. Reese hurries the pass. Tilio. Talbot forced to double back to his keeper. And what City are after in these late stages? They know their top six chances can be boosted so much if they grab a late winner here. Matthew Leckie just takes the game by the scruff of the neck. And he does win a foul in shooting range from Brad Tapp.
Temperature rising. This is in a good area. Leckie remonstrating with Jonathan Barrero. It's a good driving run from the Socceroo to draw his team a foul in a very, very good area. It's a good distance from goal.
See the foul count there, 24 total, triple made by City. Leckie was arguing there that Bogarkovic should have been given advantage, but I don't think City will mind too much that they get to come back here and crack from this set piece. Four in the wall. Haven't committed too many numbers forward here, Melbourne City. Perhaps mindful of the fresh legs the Mariners have got on for the potential counter-attack. Togay Arslan to the left side of the box. Nisbet gets it away. And now Quall can leap spectacularly for the ball. Can't find a teammate with his head. Talbot. Leckie. Every bit the catalyst here, but time is the enemy of both teams. 5 additional minutes to finish the night. Tilio. Theoharis on him this time.
Generally speaking, 5 minutes gives each team the chance to create one big opportunity.
Talbot. The ball just didn't strike sweetly off his boot there. He's sliding a little narrow away from his teammates, and so resetting on halfway is Curtis Good. Talbot. Tilio. Garkovic is making a wide run. He wasn't able to drag a defender with him, though. They all know that Tilio's the danger at the moment. He ran straight into a 1-on-3. Reese popped off the ball. Free kick, Mariners.
Nuno Race tracking Jing Reese all the way into midfield then. Giving away the foul. Looks like he's come off second best as well. I have no arguments about the foul being given away. He's hurt himself in the process.
No call for the trainer, so he's able to eventually rise to his feet. Lions will tick a little bit beyond the 95-minute mark. It'll probably be at the referee's discretion. Mariners restart and go on the attack in the meantime. Nisbet able to wheel into a pocket of space here, Josh Nisbet. And now Ballard brings it under his control. Ballard! Mariners take a stoppage time lead! Max Ballard, his first A-League goal! What a moment for the defending champions!
Well, it might be his first A-League goal, but he took it like a seasoned goal scorer. Max Ballard, the midfielder, bursting through into the Melbourne City defence and striking a dagger through their heart with what turned out to be a brilliant finish. Josh Nisbet driving at the defence on the Harvey Norman replay. Max Ballard taking on any defender willing to get close enough to him with some fancy footwork. And then the finish was unerring into the back post to give what you would imagine is an unassailable lead to the home side.
That's what I've been on the sidelines. Game number 74, Max Ballard's first goal. He debuted back in January of 2021 for the Central Coast outfit. A goal 3 years in the making. What a time to score it. And now, precious few minutes for Melbourne City to throw caution to the wind and try to answer in kind. Nuno Reyes has had to call the trainer. How important could that have been? His mobility, trying to get back after suffering the knock in the phase of play before. Nisbet was crucial in the build-up. And the way he took that chance, Mossy, it's hard to believe it's taken him 74 games to score in the A-League, because that was composure in a big moment.
Oh, he knew exactly what he was doing. Absolutely wonderful goal from Ballard. As you said, creator supreme, Josh Nisbet, found the pocket of space, drove at the Melbourne City defence, released the ball to Ballard at just the right time. Ballard had the Melbourne City defence on their heels, took full advantage. Credit to Mark Jackson. He changed things tactically at half time to a back four. Things weren't working in the first half, but Melbourne City will rue the chances they had. We spoke about the Yarkalish chance just before half time. How different this game could have been had he stuck that one away.
Minaraj has limped back onto the field. He's going to play these final few minutes, but now, we tick up to the 95-minute mark, maybe 90 seconds due to both the Reyes injury and the goal celebration, maybe another minute. Mariners will go into lockdown time-wasting protocol. Melbourne City, whatever set play they have, look at Reyes, he is really almost out of the game at the moment.
Yeah, I just wonder when he threw the back of Jing Rees, whether he copped a hip or something like that in the rib area. The sternum. Very, very painful.
If the scoreline holds, it'll be 7 points out of a possible 9 for the Mariners against Melbourne City across their series of grand final rematches during the home and away campaign. It is the same scoreline as when they met back in January. Only this time, the Mariners' goal came 5 minutes later. Tap. Tilio has paid big call. He was about to go on a run to attack.
They have had to work so hard. This is to be 3 points to the Mariners. They've had to work so hard, and credit the Melbourne City. The performance tonight has been worthy of more than nothing. That's the way it stays. It's a sign of a very good side. If you don't play at your best, you can still find the 3 points.
Nuno Reyes has come off without a replacement, so Melbourne City finishing the game with 10. Leckie starting from deep in his own half. 96 and a half minutes. Do they have one last hurrah to go forward? Can Leckie make it happen? Weaving, attempting to get past Nisbet, who fouled him. They'll have a free kick to send the house. Is Jamie Young coming up? Westland will be on delivery. Lord Willie, he's been waved forward. Jamie Young's up, but he's up to take the free kick. Last roll of the dice for Melbourne City. Young's free kick, headed away by Kaltak. Tilio taps with him. Tilio blocked away. And the full-time whistle goes! The grand final rematches keep falling in the Mariners' favour. And the hero is first-time goal scorer, Max Ballard. That's what it means on the sidelines. And there will be no sweet dreams for the Wellington Phoenix tonight, because a late goal means it is all still to play for in the race for the Premier's plate, as the Mariners close the gap with three precious points. Look at Mark Jackson, he's fired up. And the Central Coast Mariners continue to find a way. Handshakes at full time between the Gappers. And where it ended in the benches brawling last time, there is sportsmanship at full time here. These two really know how to entertain. 3-3 and a pair of 2-1s. A really good trio of home and away games. Melbourne City, their task just to play the Mariners again in the finals this season, made all that much harder by going down here tonight. Game number 74 will be a memorable one for Max Ballard. His stoppage time goal proved to be the winner. As it ended, Central Coast Mariners 2, Melbourne City 1. Phil Moss, what a finish to the game.
Magnificent. Shouldn't surprise us either with what these two teams have dished up in the past. But it was a real arm wrestle tonight. Melbourne City had the better of the first half of that, there is no doubt. Mark Jackson with some tactical tweaks and a triple substitution at half-time, I think played a crucial role in getting his team over the line tonight.
It is time to talk to our Isuzu Ute player of the match, who is the Central Coast Mariners, Danny Vukovic. Congratulations on three massive points. I know you've been in this game for a very long time, but the feeling of a stoppage time winner must be as good as ever.
And it's a winner, so it's amazing.
Oh, Vukery took it like a seasoned goal scorer. It was an incredible finish and mazy run to get there. Take us inside the dressing room at half time. What was the messages from Mark Jackson, and obviously a tactical tweak as well?
Yeah, we needed a change. I think we just couldn't get it right defensively in the first half. We couldn't get close to them. We wanted to be in their faces from the start, and we weren't able to do that. So I think the tactical change at half time really helped, and some fresh legs. It really helped. So, second half was really good, and that's what we need going into the next game.
You had a lot of work in that first half, making saves and commanding the defence, and we saw you get a bit of a treatment on your knee. Was that something you bought in or something you picked up during the game?
Mate, it's just old age, 39 years old. I wake up every morning with something sore. This knee's been a little issue the last couple of weeks, but it's all good. Got through the game and ready to go next one.
So much to play for, Vuka, and you've got yourselves in a great position. What's the mindset going into this weekend's game against Wellington?
Yeah, look, massive game, a chance to go top. Huge game. Wellington have been amazing defensively. They're very, very strong. Got a great goalkeeper in goals, and right throughout, they're solid. So we're playing at home, though. We love playing here in front of our home fans, hopefully a big one. So Mariners supporters, get out, support your boys, and hopefully we can go first after Saturday.
Congratulations on the result. Great entertainment tonight. Go and enjoy it with the boys. Danny Vukovic, thank you.
Will do. Cheers, fellas.
Thank you to Danny Vukovic, our player of the match. And the Tobin Medal points, Mossy, reflect that with your 3-2-1.
Yeah, I don't think the Mariners would have been in with a shot of winning tonight if it wasn't for Vuka, particularly in that first half. He was outstanding. Some critical saves. Arslan was very good in a beaten side tonight. He was busy all game. Everything Melbourne City did that was good came through him. And Max Ballard, well, what a goal. That deserves a point on its own. But his overall performance, I thought, was fantastic tonight as well. Great energy, and he deserved that goal.
Stick around. More aftermath to come on the other side of this short break. The Mariners win. We'll break it all down on the other side. You're watching the Isuzu Ute A-League Men's.